Hey there, my name's Drew Brashler, and in this video, I'm going to talk about why you shouldn't use this network switch with your Dante network on a Yamaha DM3 or really any Dante devices. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident in your production gear no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, this switch is a Netgear GS108. Now, this is a very common network switch that I see in a ton of different boxes at shows. And if you were to put this on your Dante network, it might work, but at some point, you will lose sync and different audio devices will become the master for your sync, and you will have tons of clocking issues and everything. I have seen this type of switch take down an entire Dante network before, and I want to tell you why. Now, these switches have EEE, which stands for Energy Efficient Ethernet, or Green Ethernet. The specific term for it is IEEE 802.3AZ, and that stands for this green Ethernet, or this EEE. Now, EEE basically turns off your Ethernet to certain devices at low network usage. So it means that a port that's not being used on a network switch, it will disable or lower the power being used on that Ethernet leg. Now, this can be fine for most networking interfaces. However, with Dante, and specifically Shure devices being on a Dante network, that will cause a ton of issues because basically it will turn off the send and receive on that Dante line unless there's active activity being sent and received on that Ethernet port. Now, what this looks like is an audio dropout or a sync issue or a clock issue. And it's even down to the point where you can't update Dante devices on the network if you're using a switch like this. We want to make sure that we're not inadvertently putting a switch on a Dante network that has EEE enabled, meaning that we want to use managed switches. Now, managed switches allow us to go in and turn on and off certain features on that network switch. Now, this is an unmanaged switch, and there's a bunch of different switches like this. There's TP-Link, there's Netgear, there's D-Link. All of those have a similar line of unmanaged switches, and they all have about the same model number, 105, 108, a bunch of different things like that. And this is why we want to use a managed switch. Netgear has a great line called the AV line, the M4250, and those switches allow us to go in and turn off EEE, which is going to be a lifesaver for any Dante network. Now, Audinate and Shure both have lists of disqualified switches. Now, that's a big term. It sounds kind of scary, to be honest, but you don't want this to take down your Dante network. So down in the description below, I have linked two PDFs, one from Shure and one from Audinate, talking about disqualified switches and what network switches you should be using on your Dante network. So if you are wanting to add some more devices on your Dante network, do not grab the wrong switch. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on really any of the production equipment that's out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.